Hello and welcome everyone to part 3 of the Saxon Let's Play for Total War Attila. We continue where we left off last time and we are besieging Londinium. Now I asked you guys in the comments whether you'd like me to fight the battle myself so you guys could see it or whether you were happy with an auto resolve. And to be honest, it's about 50-50. So what I'm going to do is fight the battle, but I'm not going to start my kind of normal recording timer for around about half an hour. 25 minutes, half an hour is normally how long I record part 4. I'm not going to start that timer until we finish this battle. So those of you that want to see the battle, also get to see the battle. And those of you that wanted to, you know, keep seeing it progress, you'll still get that. So it could be a slightly longer part. I don't think this battle's going to take too long. I'm just going to try and take these guys down at range. Many of you did say that obviously fighting this yourself, Lionheart, you're going to take more damage than the AI because the AI won't take as much damage by the towers as I will. So, yes. We'll win though, we'll get this done. Also, don't forget to check in the description now, guys. I have an upload schedule that lets you guys know when part of each of my Let's Plays for Attila are going to be released. Even though it says right at the end of the video, if you're confused, if you don't see a series on the schedule, it isn't a regular Let's Play. So that goes for most of the co-ops. That includes my Western and Eastern Roman Empire Let's Play. Because it's a co-op, we don't sit. We both have our own channels to manage, myself and Malekith. We don't have enough time to kind of, sit and make that a series that we do every day. But we will do it at least once, hopefully twice a week. We'll actually arrange to do another part of that soon. Actually, the Londinium here, actually, it's the first time I've seen it actually built up properly since I fought on this exact map, pretty much, but obviously with a lot of siege escalation on it, at EGX London, where I did the live stream. Obviously then the city had sprawled over here to this side a little bit more. And you just have the first sprawl across the Thames. The bridge, that looks pretty cool. I like this, you've got a ship being built here, the wooden frame constructed. The markets and everything. Oh, that looks awesome. Londinium, eh? Cool. Right, it's just going to be an interesting city to take. Lots of watchtowers. We obviously have these rams to try and burst on in. I'm not going to split up my forces to try and get in from different angles just because by splitting them up, I'm actually going to take more losses. I wish, actually, I could deploy over here. That'd be cool, because then I could just swarm over this bridge. Is there a... there's a ford over here. I could just go over that way and then in through the bridge. Oh, I'm so tempted to do that with a contingent. I think I'm going to send a contingent to do that while we get these guys just going for the ram here. So I'm actually going to keep both rams this side. I'm going to get those guys to jump off, go loose formation, then jump back on. It's annoying that you can't do this while they're on the ram. But that actually helps them a little bit, obviously. So we've got the spears. In that case, what I'm thinking, I might send all the spears around the flank. And we'll give them these skirmishers to go with them. We'll leave this unit of Saxon spears around here. If we send all these guys around, it'll take them a little while, but they'll be able to get across and then wander across the bridge. There's two watchtowers, but they'll be able to get right behind the enemy. Meanwhile, these guys will hold up here. And I've got my archers here as well. We'll try and set the towers on fire. See how that goes. Leave my general here. So, away we go. I'm not going to go towards the gate just yet because these guys are going to need plenty of time to get over here. Right, that's them. So actually, yeah, that's a far better way of doing it. I just do that last little bit there, the drag. So hold down shift and right click drag. And it will move your forces. It's quite cool. Very useful. So I'm just going to see where they've actually got their forces deployed. I can't see any up on the wall here, but maybe we can see the civilians almost unsuspectingly wandering around, going about their daily business. Daily lives. Bless them. Also, I should have mentioned when we were loading into this, but it went quite quickly. I've actually installed Attila now onto an SSD. I picked up a new 500 gig one. So my loading time should be a lot faster now. for Attila. I did the same thing with Rome 2 when that came out, pretty much. Well, actually not when it came out, but like about halfway through its kind of release. Probably about 10 months ago or something like that. I think I probably got an SSD or something. And that really did help speed up battle loading times and what have you. These guys are really going for it. They've got the standard there. Go, 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 go. So yeah, new SSD in there, keeping it all nice and fast. Still no official drivers from Nvidia. Apparently, I've been seeing on forums, AMD, an AMD representative has said that their drivers will be out very soon. So, if AMD are going to get theirs out, I assume Nvidia will follow. But Nvidia were really slow getting some drivers out for Robe 2. And then they complained that Creative Assembly apparently hadn't given them enough time to develop drivers or something, or the problems with Rome 2 optimization was nothing that they could actually do. This time around, I mean, they are building off Emperor Edition as a base. Obviously, optimization still isn't as great, but then until it is more demanding. But hopefully, they can still tweak it a little bit. Especially for lower-end systems, get something Creative Assembly have gone on about for a while, about how they want to look after lower-end systems as well with their games, and Attila kind of seems almost to be a bit of a slap in the face to lower-end system users. It's like, oh yeah, well, you could run our game, but we made it really more graphically intensive. Which is fine for higher-end systems, but why not have those same lower-end systems that you had for Rome 2 for people? These guys look awesome coming through here, and girls. So that's a nice mix now. You've got female warriors in here as well. Don't know how historically accurate that is. This is literally just before the period that I studied in my degree. I sort of started in about 600 AD for my history degree. I'm going to hit fast forward now, because as much as we love going cinematic mode and watching them run along the banks of the Thames, I need them in position, because I need them, if anything, drawing all the enemy forces over here. It's going to get over here and there'll be like some weird blocker that I can't go on the bridge, but this is awesome actually, that I've been able to flank around on that bridge. That's pretty cool. I like that. And yeah, then we're gonna go in here. But I think, in a way, actually, I need these guys to rest for a little bit, because they're gonna be shattered. They're already exhausted, and obviously their efficiency is gonna go down with that. Only my tier ones, so we need to sort them out. I got Hengist. I'm getting ready to lead the men into battle. There is he. Here's his force here. Furs, they're ready. I mean, how much settlement damage? There's been enough settlement damage to give them a minus one debuff on all their stats, so that's cool. Obviously, the victory point is the temple, the church at the top. Ring out the bells. Okay, right, we're gonna let all these guys rest now. Although, they've still got little drips and drabs coming on in. They're winded, they're back to being. Yeah, see, it replenishes a lot faster fatigue in this game, so which means we can attack now. This one's probably going to get defeated, that's why I'm sending it in a crappy little Nordic band. Meanwhile, all of you guys get into the square, get supported by the skirmishers. Skirmishers, actually, you need to capture this for me. I know they're all active now, and I'm just charging them back through, but obviously we want to run them through. We don't want them walking. Go, 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 men, go. Shields up as you cross the bridge. That does look pretty awesome. Oh, I've accidentally tabbed off screen. Sorry. It's the problem with having dual monitors. Sometimes I float off to the other screen. Although, actually, it may be because I think I might have left this game on. Let me check. No, I didn't run it in a window. People want to know my graphic settings. Those are my graphic settings, very quickly. I don't have unlimited video memory enabled, even though I've got plenty of memory. Mainly because that's not meant to improve performance, it's meant to improve quality, so you've got more memory to have even higher textures, and that should stop downsampling. But in the benchmark, that yielded about 5 FPS less performance, and right now, seeing as the FPS is quite close to being, you know, around that 30 FPS sweet spot of, yeah, it's okay, it could be better, I'm leaving it at kind of a place where it will support uh, 30 FPS rather than anything else. Right, I'm pushing my archers so we can try and shoot down some of these towers. We destroyed the towers. Oh, nice! That we took them down by just flooding in there. Okay, well they're not even here. They're way over the other side. So we're going to get in behind them now. Oh no, they've got cavalry. Right, all of you mob the cav. Skirmishers, get up here. Start capturing the point, please. Oh, guys, would you please just launch onto that cav there? There we go. Mob that cav. There we go. He's knocked off his horse. Speared in the face. No, we can't actually hit these towers because they're made of stone. We can try and set the gatehouse on fire. That makes sense though. Gatehouse on fire. It's made of stone rather. Can't defeat it. Cool. Right, archers pull back then.
A victory point is almost within our grasp.
Yep. There we go. Right. When you start blocking up the street so they can't get through.
Our spears are yours.
You guys over here.
Orders.
You guys hold the victory point because we're actually going to want to pull these guys over onto the sides here.
Oh, no. Destroyed our siege engines.
Oh, right, yeah. They say we've destroyed their siege engines. They've destroyed our siege engines. They haven't. It's,
The men are broken and running for their lives.
It's the fact that we've actually got in the gates. We've destroyed the gates. Our siege engines just collapse when that happens. Right, so we've got the victory point, so we're now capturing the victory point. I'm going to go capture these towers because they're being incredibly damaging and annoying. Men, get inside if you can. They've got their general ready. Oh, and they're just going to be able to pull these guys up. Pull these guys over here. So we can get this lot. They've sent these guys in. Which, pretty weak armor. But obviously a good attack. So that's fine. Skirmishers, if you can, hit their general. That would be much preferred. Alright, you guys over here. We're going to take out these towers so that we can actually get in with my men. Send my general in. And actually get my archers out of loose formation. Pull them forward as well. We want to get in inside the square. So we're going to capture here. It's going down. Oh, no, 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 guys. No, no, no. Skirmishers, why the hell are you inside? Oh, we've broken one of their units anyway. Alright, hit their general back. How many men have we lost so far? Okay, yeah. That's a siege, and we're obviously trying to capture their towers and stuff. Not too bad. Slowly capturing both these towers, so we'll be in soon. Can they not? No, they've got not a clear fire from here, have they? Have to bring them round this way. That's okay, that's okay. We should have these towers any second. That'll stop them being such a pain in the arse. Pull all these guys into the square. Archers, heavy shot into the back of their general. My general's going to go and kill them. About to capture the gateway here, which will knock down their towers. This tower's just about to go down, keeping them... I could put them in loose spacing. But this one's about to go down, so it's okay. Bye-bye, tower. Crumble, 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 crumble.
The enemy fort will belong to us.
Oh, we're about to win anyway. The victory defenders' points are gone. That's that tower, though, anyway. We've got a win. Straight for that victory point. Good way to flank in from Londinium. That's a victory.
This is your day.
But I still like the fact that we get to continue. That's pretty cool. I'm just heavy shotting them in the face. Point blank range. Rally! And I know I don't have to fight this anymore, but I am just going to charge in with everyone just to kill them. Why not at this point? Kill, kill, kill! Because they're already celebrating. Just finish killing them, please. Not that it matters. End it there. We are done. A decisive victory. So I'm going to start my timer from now. That took 14 minutes, so get a nice little bonus there. So there we go. Londinium is ours. An axe to the back of the neck. Decisive battle. And victory. And we are going to... we could loot and occupy. Claim plunder, provincial instability. Yeah. I think we will just occupy in that sense. Then, yeah, we don't want to plunder it too much because we need some food going, like, pretty quickly. What's this? Squalor. Oh, that enables for spies, which I have to convert to the market stall. Oh, they don't even have enough population surplus for more food. Are we building more food? Jetty, we need that to fishing jetties then. Devastation from battles, buildings. Okay, fertility. Right. Yeah, we're going to get a rebellion in Londinium anyway, so we have to fend off some rebels. But, oh, actually, here we go. We'll get some more food in this province. Commanded force. Yeah, that's fine. When's that kick in, though? Hang on. From characters. Oh, when Horde. Commanded force. Well, it should be the same. No, it's probably only not. Let's reset them then, because that's not doing anything. I think that's when commanded forces in when you're a Horde. So only when you're a governor. So if I've got any governors, they can be upgraded. We'll do that. Construction cost. Yes, that. No, again, that's governed province. I need to stop looking at that. I need to look at probably infantry commander for him. I could do for sacking and looting, but I obviously didn't do that. We'd go for raiding. Melee cav. We haven't got any melee cav yet. So in that case, We will go for despoiler for now. And that army is actually a traditions to get as well. Ambush chance, morale, during forest battles, integrity when in own or allied territory. Yeah, we'll boost that because their integrity is actually quite low. Ah, growth. That's what we need for local province. A local province. Nice. Let's do that. So now that's increasing that there. We want to set this. Yeah, that's already on resettlement. Good. Want the growth. Want the public order. We need to convert that to a burg. It's a large city. But we can't do that yet because we need 10k. So, yeah, that's going to be fun, saving up for that. But we should be able to do it if we can start raiding as well. We were bringing my other army over here to help out, actually. And I've got one I was just building up here to hold in case we have a war with the Langobards kicking off. We'll need to defend there. But as many of you said, if I lose Frisia, not to worry too much. Focus on conquering Britain right now. So I'm bringing up this army so we can start taking more of the Roman lands. We'll be doing that next turn. Then we can obviously raid and we can sack and pillage and have lots of fun. So that's fine. I think that's all we need to do there. So let's end the turn. Keep pushing. There we go. We got it's Britonic Rebels. I think they'd be called Britain Rebels or something like that. But we've got Britonic Rebels spawned just between Londinium and Camlodunum there. Should be able to take them down. I would hope. We need to claim some land before the Vikings appear and maybe even the Angles. We've got them as our... Actually, no, I forget. No need to worry about that. I'm trying to remember, because obviously, like, we've got the Danes and the Saxons both kind of covering a similar area. I'm trying to remember who I've got treaties with. Right, terms of office here. Horsa has finished his. A worthy bride. You're 40, she's 40. Yeah, okay, give blessing. Balance of power, yes, will have shifted, because control shifted a little bit. But we don't want any higher than this, really, because we start getting all sorts of big public order problems and growth weaknesses and everything else. So it's this guy. He's just gained a wife. So we've got Eomer. So as many of you went, oh, look, Lord of the Rings reference. Yeah, I mean, that says, as many of you said, Rohirric or Rohirrim. I think it's Rohirric is... the culture and not language, is it, of Rohirrim, but the culture of the Rohirrim of Rohan. Very much descends from old English, old sort of Norse English and things like that you've got coming in here. So the Saxons and what have you will see some probably familiar names potentially. So we've got Eomer, we'll definitely get him in, make him a mighty horse lord. So Hengist and Horsa ready to go to war. Who have we got here? This guy here, and nope. Here we go. So Horsa can go up to it being an elder. You become one of these, chap. Elsa. There's a general, right. We've got Senred over there. Cool. So over here we have a daughter and we have an illegitimate son. Annoyingly, we need these guys to... You're still not having sex. Have the sex. Go on. She's a sexy jute girl. She's got extra cunning. Go on. Wow. Arriba. They clearly need to go watch 50 Shades of Grey. That'll get them in the mood. And speaking of the jutes invading, they are here. So let me just reevaluate the allies and what have you. So we've got the Jutes as defensive allies and the Angles, and that's good because they're going to stop them screwing me over. I've actually, in my spare time, I've been trying out a Jutes campaign. The Angles screwed me over completely and they took out my Jute settlement here. The Jutes have actually, in that campaign that I'm playing, we fled all the way over to Wales and we're slowly pushing back into Britain now. But, that's why I kind of pushed to take these guys out, because I know the Angles are normally tricky, tricky bastards. So we've sorted that out. Apart from that, not a lot of friends about. We've got to keep the Franks off us for as long as possible, because otherwise they'll start just ruining everything. These guys, I'd love to get trade with you, but we don't have a connected province, and yeah, not willing to trade. So we'll leave that there. We've got these rebels here. That's happy there, though. We're going to go... Can we land normal stance? Yes, we can. So let's land at Camlodunum. And then, yeah, instantly, let's go out and take out these rebels. Or at least knock them back there. Then we'll jump back to Camlodunum, and then we'll sally out here to finish them off. It's going to be an auto-resolve this time, so we're going to go for protective stance because we have the missile superiority. It will do less damage. In fact, actually, I kind of want to go for aggressive because I want more casualties. I want to wipe them out. I don't want them being able to come back and flee. So actually, no, I've changed my mind. I'm going aggressive, so they're dead. Boom. Okay, and we will replenish, take on warriors. We lost a unit of spears, but that's fine. I'm not too torn up about that. Enemy killed in battle. Nice. Good. Job done. Right, so now we've got to save up our funds. thankfully, it's only going to cost 9,000 now that we've got the construction cost lowered there. I think we'll go for... We've got market stalls to get spies, which will get us a lot of wealth. Or that will get us a load of public order. Meeting hall. Our food consumption is back up, which is good. So you don't have to worry about that. That will allow us to get better troops in the end, but that will allow us to get a spy and more money. So I'm going to probably go for spy and more money right now. Because we're already going up for a chieftain's house over here, so that's fine. So we'll do that, unless we were going for a market stall there. Not sure. We'll see what that is before we do anything else. Right. So now we've got our forces here. They've got rebels up here. And that's been taken. So probably, seeing as that province is quite happy, we should probably send these guys over here. And we're going to attack Corinium, and take that. So we have the whole of Britannia Superior under our control. That's getting loads of growth. That's fine. We can upgrade these. We'll upgrade Londinium next, obviously. Ah, we can already get a spy. Oh, yeah, because that can. Oh, we can still get it, even though... Oh, cool. So we can still get spies, even though we don't actually... It's not our building. It's the Roman building that was left behind. And it's not repaired. That's fine. Cool. So I can actually get a spy if I want. That'd be useful. Right, end the turn again. Unassigned skill. Let's increase that tax rate. He is... Or Horsa, you are governor? You are a governor. Where have I put you as a governor of? Oh, Britain Superior. Perfect. Tax rate increase, please. And then we'll go for that, because we've got to unlock that to get any of the other abilities. Local province, faction-wide, public order, local province. Yeah, we'll pop that in there. There he is. Horsa will have his garrison. Right. And the turn again. Yeah, it looks like the Jutes have exactly the same idea as me to take Corinium. So we're going to need to push there before they do. I know they're defensive allies, but obviously I don't want them expanding above me too much. It looks like they missed out on Lindum. Oh, and we've got the... Who have we got? The Picts charging down with a full army. Chasing the barbarians there. I'll go hit protective. Oh, right in his face. The only thing... I mean... The faction that appears when you get rebels in Britain is obviously Britain. But it's like a Roman Britain that's... rebels that are re-emerging, because they have all the cohorts and Roman-type units. So, rather than it being like, you know, like the Picts or Caledonians, like a barbarian-type tribe or something like that, so that's interesting. We will replenish. We lost a few men in that. Went protective for a reason. Don't you dare go take Corinum. Yeah, get out of my land. I don't think you had permission. Sod off. Or I will claim my vengeance. Don't make me go Liam Neeson on you. I will look for you. I will find you. And I will kill you. I actually saw his ad on YouTube the other day for Clash of Clans. Angry Neeson 56 or whatever it was. Or 52. That actually alone makes me kind of want to play Clash of Clans, even though I've never played it. And I know it's kind of just a mobile game. But that's the way to get to me. Use Liam Neeson to... advertised to me. So what's this? Oh, okay, we tried to put him into a higher position of power. And he's been blocked. So we could hit his own influence, or we could use my faction leader's influence. I kind of would like to diminish his influence a little bit here, the actual guy Horsa, because he's not of my family. He's other nobles, so I don't want him getting too powerful. So we'll go, he can afford it as well. Political, yeah, there we go. Because he's over here. So he's fine. He's fine. This is just my family that I've got to look after. Who has got a legit daughter, illegitimate son. Do you guys, why? Look, do you need a demonstration of how to have the sex? Christ. Just have a... Do it. Come on. It's been Valentine's Day recently and everything. You could have got in there and just, you know, woo! Saxon sex. Ready? Nope. Apparently not. Ugh. Cavalry commander, then we can go up to war chief if we want, which is quite useful. We have to have a bit in all of these, and then eventually we can become a legend, which is really rather cool. I think we're going to go for that so we can increase our integrity for the commander force. Unit experience for cavalry units, yeah. This guy would be perfect, actually, if he was instead AMR. Right, this army, we're going to go over here and take it, because otherwise I don't think there's going to be a city because the Duke's coming. And we're going to auto-resolve this one as we push on in. We're going to go protective, try and minimise our losses. There we go, that worked well. We've got them Saxon Mounted Warband, Nordic Mounted Raiders, lots of fun with them. And they go, and we could sack, but again, I kind of want to stabilise the region rather than destabilise it all the time. I know we get a bonus from looting. That's going to do more damage to the settlement, although we do need them. I'm just going to occupy. Kind of thinking, I'm trying to be a nice Saxon that's invading these lands. Just want to be a nice Saxon. Well, I can't build fields, apparently, and I can't even repair it, so let's get rid of that. A fountain can be converted to a well for sanitation and growth. Sanitation to all regions in this province. Ah, cool. I was thinking that earlier. I was looking at, I think it was my, must have been my Danes or, yeah, must have been my Danes, not my Huns. Must have been the Danes Let's Play. And I was thinking, or maybe it was my Dukes Let's Play. I'm not doing any Dukes Let's Play, sorry. My Dukes campaign that I was playing privately, rather. Thinking, how the hell are you meant to, with a city that only has 4 slots, be able to build up all these buildings and be able to sort out the sanitation? Makes sense that the sanitation is province-wide. So I am going to convert that, actually. It's going to be a first order of business, but once we've got the Berg, probably. I don't know, we'll probably start convert everything but the Berg first. Get that all set up and what have you. So we've now got the whole of the province. Now, I wish that would actually boost the edict or make the edict more powerful, to be honest, because it seems silly to be able to have edicts individually and then not for when you... And there's no extra bonus having all of them. Makes them a little bit less important, I think. But oh well. Right, so we've claimed the whole south of Britain. The Picts have managed to swoop in here. I'm not too keen about that, so we will probably go to war with the Picts and push them north once we've taken back Wales, if we can. We might see if we can swoop round them, take this settlement province capital, and then take that in between. And we'll just keep pushing north and get rid of them. Then we'll take out the Abdanians, control the whole of Britain, probably then start invading the Western Roman Empire lands in Gaul. It might be at this time that we can take out the Franks and squeeze them here. Probably keep this as our easternmost point for now, our capital. That's one thing, I don't think you can change your capital. Where will we go for details? Here we go. Yeah, so as far as I can see, there's nowhere that says make this my capital, which would be great if there's a little button there. Because I remember, and it's the feature I really liked in Medieval 2, that the further you had your capital away, like the further you sent your merchants and stuff, or the further away you established trade, the more you got. But also, you got a public order, you got a more negative public order the further away, like, your frontier settlements were from your capital. So you ended up actually shifting your capital to, like, a more central region later on in your campaign, so that it would better kind of represent your empire. So if you played as, like, the British, and you started off and, you know, conquered all of England, then you went through France and you went over to the Holy Land, you'd probably end up actually establishing your capital somewhere in Rome, just because that would be quite central to where your empire would be. And, I mean, the Romans themselves, they moved north to Mediolanum. They moved their capital there, and it was at Ravenna as well. They moved north with their capital. It's a better seat of power for them there. But and obviously because Rome was sacked a couple of times. Yeah, it was always thought it'd be especially in Attila, where it is about, you know, can you make your empire survive? You may well have to shift. It may be better to shift your capital somewhere else. I don't know if capitals give a bonus or not to public order in this game, but I might actually make a thread on the Total War Centre forums, actually, as like a feature request. Because I don't think that'd be too difficult to implement, because your capital already changes when you lose one. It goes to your next one, which I assume is probably your next... Which I think, actually, would it go to the next wealthiest one, or... I don't know. Probably. I mean, you could make it cost, so that, you know... We've got a, yeah. Yeah, we need to build now the farmstead. That's what it is. That can be, I've got 7,000 for that, and about 9,000 for that. Convert that, but you've got to wait for it to be repaired first, so I'll repair it. Not convert, I'm going to build the fishing jetties as well for more food. That's taking out our economy, but that establishes our food, so we should be fine there. Oh, I've got to convert that, damn it. Camlodonum, you've now got a chieftain's house, so you're going to go up that route. So if I convert that to market stalls, then we'll be okay there. Yeah, we're all taking attrition. Oh, no. Oh, damn, they've taken... Oh, no, the Abdani's taking that. Right, so we'll have to go to war with the Picts. Or we could take out the British. Well, I haven't discovered them yet, so I can't take them out. Okay, fine. End turn. But yeah, let me know what you think about that feature, guys. And if you think strongly or you support that, then let me know. Oh, the jutes be a-raisin. Then let me know, and I will I'll make a thread on Total War forums. And get some support going for it. So it looks like the Angles are pushing against the and the Jutes against the Western Roman Empire there. And they're not even bothered about holding and taking land, they're just raising as they go. A bit of a buffer, always useful. It looks like they're going to go and attack there. Yeah, the angles are really pushing it. They've just gone in and raised. Wow. Rome is getting wrecked in Northern Gaul. I don't know why they pulled back there. I would have charged on in. They clearly had enough movement points. It wasn't about not enough action points. They've got their faction leader, their High King there as well. We're going to push against the Picts. Attrition. Yes. But it's fine. We're building up our food. Honest. Be done in one more turn. That's converting to a well, or that's converting so I can have spies. We're going to do... I don't know if we'll get the... If we surely already have the wealth bonus. Oh, so we converted it to our own. Can't convert that yet, but we'll do that next time. Send reds, increased in rank. Cool, and hang on, who was that trespasser? The Jutes. Yeah, it's okay. I didn't mean to come up here, I meant to go let's go somewhere completely different. I meant to go over here, and... over here. Can you have anything here that'd be useful? Not for a governor. And he is over in Frisia. Let's lower, increase integrity for a commander force, but let's lower corruption, which overall yield us more money. It's always good. No one having kids. Why are you two so frigid? Seriously, just jump on each other. Everyone else having illegitimate babies? Why don't you have a legitimate one? Go on. It's just me there while they're doing it going, go on, make a baby. That'd be creepy. Don't invite me to your bedchamber. Thank you very much. Oh dear. Angles, they're going around. I think they're still looking to just raid and pillage. So they're not interested in settling. They're just raiding the Western Romans. Whereas I'm looking to make an empire. And fail at staggering a yawn as well. Because I'm just woken up. Okay, Imperium's increased. That's cool. And good. We've finally researched militarized society. We get to the smithy. Right, we've now got a brigade from Nordic Band. Nordic Warriors. Elite Nordic Warriors. Oh, cool. Nordic Raid Leader. So that increases our Warband Leader. Elite Dugoth Spearmen. They replace Saxon Spears. That's cool. Improved Incendiary Warfare. Nice. Attrition, minus 30% when laying siege, all forces. I swear we don't you don't take attrition though, when you're besieged though. I swear I haven't seen it. Is attrition naturally in game or not? That costs as well. These ones cost. Anyone know how attrition works yet? We're going to go start going for some of these to build up, because we've gone along the military tech tree for a little while. Food's back up, which is nice. Let's convert that to a well to sort out sanitation. Mainly, it's Londinium sanitation. So if we get that well converted over, that should be useful. And it's giving us more growth as well, so we can upgrade Londinium. We need to get just some military buildings, really, if we want to build up our power. We also need to get that burg converted like nobody's business. Thirsty for battle. These guys can all be upgraded though, which is good. We'll retrain them. Nordic Brigade! So, that is going well. Going pretty well indeed. I don't think there's anything else we need to do this turn. It's just construction. Factions are the Caledonians. Yeah, that's they're up here. They're not super friendly. Could be worse. In fact, I probably should just have a look over at Frisia. Because I've not done anything over here for a while. I've built the granary, which will get us more stalls and sanitation. Oh, wow, that's really useful for sanitation, actually. Damn, I didn't realise how good that was. Which means that we have... faces no risk of outbreak of disease. Sweet! Go from a small city to a city. Bailiffs we need for that. Right, let's end the turn. Oh yes, talking about cities, there was something I did read and it has been now confirmed. So it's something I've not actually seen happen yet in the game. Maybe some of you have already got to late game stages and what have you. But it has been confirmed by some members on the forums that when you upgrade a minor settlement enough, you actually get walls being built. Like proper walls, not just little palisades. You can actually build proper walls, which is a feature I'm pretty sure I went on and on about wanting in the early days of Rome 2's release, saying it would be amazing if you do that. In fact, not just the early days of Rome 2's release, I mentioned it all the time. I'm so happy to see that feature in, but I'm not like claiming that's my idea, because I'm pretty sure loads of people have the same idea, but it's great to see that in here. I can't wait to try it out for myself and just, you know, start making minor settlements kind of protected with full-on walls. That's awesome. Rank gained, Horsa. He is doing well for himself as the governor. He'd be a good governor. He can get up to judge now as well. Damn. We can improve food from the governor province, which is what we're going to do. And we're going to make him... we're going to upgrade him. He's been elder right now, but we're going to pop him up one. Pop up one! More food, please. More food, governor! We could upgrade that to the troughs for more sanitation. Okay, so it gives you a sanitation to this province plus a bonus to other regions as well, to all other ones in the region. Okay. Okay, so it still doesn't beat having your own one. That's good, right? So if we upgrade that again, it'll go from plus one to plus two in all regions, and that should sort out Londinium. Or I could upgrade that for more public order, but no, we're fine for public order. That's going to be built soon. That's going to cause some squalor, actually. So actually, I probably should upgrade that just to cover myself and for more growth. And then, I don't know, I'm going to go for the burg first at Londinium. Ready for orders. I'm not going to go to war with the Picts just yet. Don't know if we need to. Well, we could go and push on them. I mean, I can sail around up here and take the province capital, but I don't have any siege equipment yet. Obviously, I could look to try and hire a mercenary Onager. No, they're the same region. Why am I being that? Right, let's upgrade these guys. But, yes, nothing else to do there. Right, end the turn again. I think I'm going to have quite a few quick end turns now just to build up the old economy. Western Roman Empire fleeing, trying desperately to consolidate. Thing is, I guess, well, the Western Roman Empire is crumbling. From what I've played, is obviously the more regions you actually lose, the actual more stable your economy gets, because you don't have so many failing settlements and economies and armies trying to upkeep the ball all over the place. So maybe Maybe Rome does strike back later on, but I don't know. I think it's if you can keep them crumbling, they can never kind of stop that. We're going to decree it, because I've got 91 influence here. Let's do that. Food shortage resolved. Nice. Development. Good. Good. Population surplus as well. Splendid. We can upgrade Londinium. Londinium. And we could get an iron smelter, because that is our province resource. Which is not what I planned on getting, but we could do that later for iron. We'll obviously increase our trade. We get a granary if we want to. Well, that improves our own sanitation. So we could do that, but I would quite like to get an artisan so I can start going off on some, well, building up better military units. We need to get a church or a temple of some kind, because the whole province is zilch on Germanic paganism. So I mean, we're 41% Germanic paganism within our faction. Other religions, Arian Christian. We're okay right now. All right, so let's go save up the money so we can get that burg. Keep building up our forces. So we're going to push through a couple of quick end turn times. We're going to build this up to an artisan, which that will get us some money as well, wealth from industry. So that's worth going for. Then it's full on burg mode. Burg, 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 burg. And obviously we can upgrade the pastures later on to get more animal husbandry. But yeah, for now we're going to be pushing towards that burg. So the next part probably full of some campaign action, but hopefully we'll be ready to attack the Picts by the end of it. I'm going to go for labor service now so I can improve my agricultural buildings wealth generated and unlock the next few buildings there. Then we'll also look to go over to the Great Hall. Actually, no, I'm going to go over to the Great Hall first. Great Hall. Cultural buildings. Then we'll go over to that one. Right, so that's where I'm going to wrap up for now, guys. We've managed to secure the whole of southern Britain. We look north now. So until next time, don't forget to comment, subscribe, follow me on Facebook and Twitter, take pride, join the Legion. All links are in the description, as is the new upload schedule. Until next time, ciao for now.